Should I go on a, should I go have a monologue again about how much I love my friends?
I know he wanted to be honest.
Welcome to Lutterville. We're going on the ski trip on Saturday. Caitlin's coming. My latest style at fashion inspo is Helena Bonham Carter. I've only seen her. She's really famous for her roles as Bellatrix Lestrange, also in Sweeney Todd. So this is her. This is my grandma. This is my new urban cardigan. My flatmate's top. Hand warmers. It's really cool. Really fun. Let me know if you like it down in the comments below. Follow my Instagram if you want to see more. But yeah. Love you all.
Gigi's segment. It's like a regular thing now. I love it.
Nice. Hello.
Darling, we're at Strasbourg, Saint Denis, darling. It's a different area. On air, let's.
Hey guys. Basically, I really want to sort out my room. So, apparently, this is what this wall looks like. And, like, there's nothing wrong with it. It's fine. But I want it to be a bit more, you know. I feel like there's not enough going on. So, I have a Vogue magazine here. And I have a Elle magazine from 1959. So this is a vintage Elle magazine. I actually got this from one of the kiosks just along the Seine in Paris. If you ever come to Paris, you'll see when you walk along the Seine, there's all these like kind of green boxes and they kind of just sit there like on the wall, and you can buy secondhand books, antiques, vintage magazines, posters. And they're known as the Bouquinistes de Paris. So I picked up this, which was like, I don't know, €5 or something. And I also got this. I got a poster of this painting because I've always really liked this painting. It's a Gustav Klimt. It's really famous. Like, you've probably seen it. But it was really cheap for how big it is. Like, I'm pretty sure this was like €5. And it's massive. But yeah, so I'm going to stick this up and then hopefully collage with my magazines that I got. Honestly, I love walking around Paris because I always end up buying like a new poster or something. I don't know, I go to uni in Paris, which is why I live here. And I've had a lot of you messaging me being like, oh my god, like, how do I move to Paris? Like, if I can't speak French, or like, how do I learn enough French before I move there? And that's why I want to talk about today's sponsor, which is Lingoda. Lingoda is an online language school where classes take place via Zoom. They offer classes in English, business English, Spanish, German, and French. And they offer a range of different classes for a range of different abilities, beginner, intermediate, advanced, and you're really encouraged to expand on the skills of reading, listening, writing, comprehension, and the culture of the language that you're learning about. So I tested out the B2 French class, and obviously there was such like a range of topics that you can study, from climate change to literature. So Lingoda offers several different learning plans which have varying intensity and length, which makes it really flexible for you. So you have the subscription plan for the flexible learner, which is a very relaxed pace. You get to choose between 1, 3, 5, or 10 lessons per week, and each class starts from €8 and you pay every 4 weeks. So the flexible learner plan, you can change or cancel at any time, so it's perfect for students who prioritize convenience. And then you have the committed student plan, which is much more preferred by students who kind of already know that they really want to commit to learning this language and they're committed to doing it for a longer period of time. So under this plan you have 3, 6, and 12 month period options. You pay up front, but you end up saving money because each class ends up starting from €6 instead of €8, and if you attend at least 90% of the classes you will get up to €400 cash back, which is pretty amazing. There's nothing like a refund to motivate you to do something. However, regardless of whatever plan you choose, there is a 7-day free trial, and during this 7-day period you can choose to do 3 group lessons or 1-on-1 lesson. And in the group lessons there is a maximum of 5 students per class, so it's very intimate. You're still gonna get a lot of help and every student really gets a chance to participate. You're basically guaranteed individual feedback because of this. If you would like to find out more about Lingoda, you can click on the link in my description and you can receive a 30% discount on your first payment if you decide to continue with Lingoda after the 7-day free trial. Everybody go learn French on Lingoda, and then you can come to Paris and be friends with me, and we can also be French together and have a great time. I'm gonna start collaging now. I've already ripped this out of the Elle magazine and I haven't really got a plan, but I feel like I'm kind of just gonna start cutting stuff up and see what happens. Got my blue tack from HEMA. If you live in France, HEMA is amazing and you should go there because they literally sell everything. It reminds me a bit of Tiger, and they literally have everything. Like, it's really reasonably priced as well. Like, they have stationery, makeup, kitchen appliances, bathroom stuff, homeware stuff, electrical appliances. Like, they just have everything. Where did my scissors go? The only pair of scissors I could find are these ones which, like, you use in primary school. So, hopefully they're good enough. I got back from skiing yesterday in Val d'Oran. It was my first time ever skiing. Ski vlog is coming soon. I literally, like, had never skied in my life. And I stepped on the skis and I was like, I literally almost started crying. So I was like, I can't do this. But then thankfully Loz and Lizzie spent like most of the first day with me, pretty much the whole of the first day. They taught me like how to stop, how to turn, just like foundational techniques. And by the end of the day, I landed a green slope, which I was like so happy about, because my motivation was to be able to get to apres-ski, which is like the bars at the top of the mountain where they have like a DJ and like drinks and stuff. But the only way you can get there is by skiing. So like the whole day I was like, I want to get to apres. Look at that. That's sick. She's in the roof. Famous French actress. I can't remember her name though, but she's in the new Wes Anderson film, The French Dispatch, which I loved, by the way. Oh no, guys, look who it is. Emily in Paris. Literally the worst show ever. It's laughable, like, how bad it is. I can't believe it won an Emmy. It won an Emmy, right? I'm pretty sure. And it beat I May Destroy You, which is honestly the best TV show I've ever seen. I went to the Vogue show recently. Well, I didn't actually go, obviously, because I would not get invited. But because it was Fashion Week in Paris, like it's always freaking Fashion Week. And loads of my friends are like really, like they know all about models and like fashion. I don't really know about models. Like, I'm very like unaware of that whole world, to be honest. I don't really get starstruck by models either. Like, I get very starstruck by like actors, like singers, and I don't know, like people like that. Where, like, if I saw, like, I don't know, Florence Pugh, middle of the street, like, I would die, probably. I wouldn't know what to say. But if I saw, like, Kendall Jenner, like, two of my friends saw Kendall Jenner just, like, on a balcony. I mean, I'd probably definitely react. If we'd be like, oh my god, it's Kendall Jenner! But then, like, wouldn't be like, oh my god, what do I say? Anyways, the editor of Vogue, this is what I'm trying to say. The editor of Vogue went up to my friend Izzy and told her that she was really cool and that he loved her outfit. And I think that's pretty sick, so.
La mer.
Zoe Kravitz is in here. She's so cool.
La mer. On va danser le long des golfes. On va danser le long des golfes. Le long des golfes. On va danser le long des golfes.
Okay, so I basically finished up for the evening because I really just can't do anymore. I'm so hungry and tired. I've been doing this for about 2.5 hours, probably more. I was in such like a hyperfixation mode, like I literally really need to pee and I didn't realize I needed to pee until now. I'm gonna stop now, but I'm really happy with how it looks so far. So much more that I can stick up at the other end of the room. So yeah, the reason I'm doing this as well is because I'm actually filming a apartment tour. So I've told like all the other girls, make sure your room is ready, because I'm gonna go into my room and all my flatmates' rooms as well and show everything. I'm gonna go and sort myself out because I'm tired and hungry and need to pee.
It's like 4 o'clock.
Morning.
Good morning.
Morning. You want the matcha clogs?
Oh, yummy.
I know, it goes so like bitty at the end. How's everyone feeling after last night?
I'm pretty good. I didn't have a lot to drink.
Yeah, so. Fair enough. I like your eyeliner. It's cool. Glitter. Look at that, glittery.
My head was
euphoria. Yeah, yeah. I can't. I'm gonna like overdo it with the euphoria music at this point. Oh, I keep using it. God, I look like a rat and I feel like one. We don't care that we're hungover, we're still spending the day at the Louvre.
This is my first time actually going to the Louvre, like not for an exhibit.
Oh.
Like the general, like
the general
permitting.
One.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. I've only been once and I don't really remember it, so. Your G string.
Yeah. Whale tail. What the fuck?
No. What's a whale tail?
It's where you get like underwear and like you have low waisted pants.
And you stick it. Yeah.
And it looks like
it looks cool, but I didn't know it was called whale.
Someone like was talking about like my style. They're like, it's a whale tail. I'm like, what the fuck did you just call me?
I'm gonna add Swedish to my Duolingo so I can speak to Elsa Rutin in Swedish. It's gonna be great.
Do you know any Swedish?
Call me a
fritta.
Pizza.
Call me a frita. For any Swedish people around here right now, they're gonna be like, oh my god. Yeah, wait, actually teach something useful in Swedish to the vlog. Not something rude.
Tack. That's like, thank you.
Tack.
I also know you're not supposed to say thank you when someone blesses you in Swedish. Yeah. You guys taught me that.
Oh,
she
what?
Told you that. I didn't know that.
Just say like, I appreciate it.
Like if you sneeze. If you sneeze.
Bless you. Just say, I appreciate it.
Like, how do you say that?
Upsketas.
Upsketas. Okay, let's do a little role play.
Achoo! Bless you.
Upsketas.
But you haven't said it in Swedish.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, you did. Kind of.
She said it Upsketas. In English.
I said it in English.
Okay, let's go again. Ready?
Role play. One more time.
Prosit.
Upstakas.
almost.
Wait, say it again.
Upskattas.
Upskattas.
Yeah.
Wow, it's sunny. Yes. Cody speaks like four languages.
I do.
So what is your favorite language to speak and why?
It depends on what, like, if I, like, what kind of mood I'm in.
Ah, like, okay. Oh,
yeah. I always default to...
If he's in a sexy mood, he's like, I'm gonna whip out the Italian.
When I get angry, I... speak in Spanish.
Yeah, you do.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah.
And
yeah,
then,
you and Marie always fight.
Oh, in Spanish, I've heard that, and I was scared. I was like, bro. Yeah, literally.
I'll just be like, pero qué coño hace, ¿sí?
No, you do it with that.
¿Qué estás haciendo, eh? ¿Me estás mintiendo?
You go so much deep.
Pitch of my voice will change depending on what language I'm speaking.
That's so true, actually. Because when I speak French, I feel like my voice goes lower.
Yeah, same.
Yeah.
I think it actively makes it go lower. Because
yeah.
Because
it's hard. Because you know, like, in between, like, when French people are, like, thinking of words, they go like, but
you can't do like,
that's, yeah, exactly. What's your favorite then? So it depends on the mood.
I don't really have a set mood for French. I don't know, because I use it in my daily life. And I only really speak Italian with a select number of people. I'm learning Bulgarian because two of my best friends from back home, their parents are from Bulgaria. Really, it's more so I'll switch to Spanish when I'm angry, but also sometimes I have to yell at people in French.
Oh, we live in France. There's always a place to yell and complain. In Paris, yeah. C'est quoi ton problème? Right, let's go inside, guys. Oh, that's the argument. What do you think? I feel like it's interchangeable. Bit of a catch 22. Without either one of them, you can't.
There's no
point.
There's
yeah.
No point either.
No.
I'm saying without one of them, are you there's okay? No point to either. Without art, without art, there's no point to life, and without life, there's no point to art.
Yeah, I agree. Because if I lived a life without art, I think I would probably just be so miserable.
Oh yeah, like there's no music.
No music.
You can't put earth without art.
Where are all the Stockholmies at?
I asked them, I was like, what do you call someone from Stockholm? And they're like, Stockholmers. And I was like, petition to change that to Stockholmies.
Oh cool. Parc de Saint-Cloud. J'ai vécu juste à côté l'année dernière.
People, they don't say ha ha ha, they say ah ha ha.
They do say that ah ha ha. To me, like, texting ah ha ha is like an awkward laugh. Like, yeah. Ah ha ha. It's either ah ha ha or MDF. Yo, what's this? An art project.
I like it.
So, are you judging me?
No, we're not.
Oh, I know. I don't really care though. Like, I'm literally so over French people judging me for vlogging. Like, are they making money from making videos?
No.
They actually make real money.
That's so true though. Literally facts, literally facts. I make no money from this. I got a payment of 54 euros from Google Island the other day. Like, you know, my ads on my videos.
That's 54 more euros than I have though.
Yeah, wait, what the hell? 54 euros?
Yeah, to be fair, 54 euros. That was over like 2 months ago.
You know how many IKEA hot dogs you can buy?
That's true. Like, that's so true. I didn't even think about that.
108
probably literally.
So basically, every time I get paid for my AdSense, I'll just think about how many hot dogs I'm getting, and then it's basically like really valuable.
Like, well, I'm saying, like, you can eat the IKEA veggie hot dogs for 50 centimes. And if you have that as every meal, which obviously you're not going to because that's horrible.
No. Oh, you look like Tina from Boots Burgers. But she's like...
Why am I the only one popping my fucking pussy right now?
This is different than that of a lot of normal classical and neoclassical statues.
Yeah.
Because normally they stand in contrapposto, which is
how would they normally start? Like, oh yeah, that's so true.
Like,
yeah.
You're just standing like this.
Yeah.
He's going somewhere.
He's the god of gardens. Of course he's for me.
That's so true.
You know the joke that he's like really short?
Oh yeah!
Short king.
He looks really tall here though.
But he actually wasn't short. He was the average height for
that time.
At that time.
I fell in love with everyone who sit here in sketch sculptures.
I brought my little sketchbook.
Oh, you did?
Oh,
you
want to love with me?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Shut up. That's so cute. You're actually going to sketch it.
And I'm like...
Wow. This is how I yearn out my window every morning.
She's lying with a spare right here in this place.
Oh.
To finally meet you guys. Yeah. I'm grateful I got to be in the vlog.
Nice to meet you. Enchanté.
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 Till the road, guys.
Bisous. Puss. Fitta. Puss. Puss. On YouTube.
Celebrity.
Well, tell them what we're doing.
So we're just about to go out for Alex's birthday.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a really good night.
Uh-huh.
So everyone's gonna wear Crocs.
It's Croc Society night, babes, do you know what I mean?
So these like London Paris vlogs and you just like walk around going around Paris.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't believe Alex hasn't told you because he's in them.
I want to see them.
I'm so angry at you. There's an episode where we went to the all-night library together and we were like trying to finish our essays.
Oh my god, everyone, send the link down below. Did we get that? Rewind.
Down below.
Ellie's just attacked me.
Attacked in the video, attacked in Paris.
Clickbait.
Yeah.
No, not clickbait. Oh my god. Jesus Christ, I don't know what's got into this one.
What friendship has changed after being famous? I mean, famous with friends, who's the famous
friends
person?
I feel like my friendship with Caitlin, so the moment I met her, I knew, wow, she's famous. So it's cool. So like, oh my god, it's Caitlin's birthday.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I didn't, because I didn't know you didn't know you were famous at that point.
Yeah.
Actually, I became friends with you over the course of your horizon to fame. Horizon, rise to fame.
I actually was staying over at her house when I reached 1k followers.
Yes, so yes. Do you think that Lauren helped your fame?
Oh, what? Couldn't have done it without her.
Right.
Couldn't have done it without her, honestly.
Right, I'm the reason for her fame, actually. The only reason.
Oh, those 20,000 people came because of you, Lauren.
Yeah.
That was nothing to do with me.
Everything
you want
for me.
Yeah.
Understandable. Yeah. Understandable.
Yeah.
Je suis une fleur. Je suis une très jolie fleur. Je suis plus jolie qu'une rose et je sens meilleur qu'un lilas. Qui suis-je? Je suis toi.
It's in the vlog.
What do you want me to say, my darling?
No, wait, hey, camera
red pressure now.
Okay, so sell Crocs up. Can you ASMR?
Yeah, ASMR.
Hi everyone, welcome to Croc Society.
Salut, ça va?
Ça va et toi?
Welcome to the Croc Society.
Maddie
and I
love her.
I am the president of the Croc Society.
And Paris,
the Croc Society.
Macron, Benny Macron.
And we've organised drinks and everyone's wearing their
Crocs. Wait, can I get a close up of your
Yes, please.
Close up.
Because I don't go to Europe and I don't have Crocs, so I'm exempt from this.
Wow. Maddie, you're ruining the show.
Merci beaucoup.
Wow. Oh.
The cheapest drink in the bar.
Wow. You lip Crocs up on Instagram.
It's the leader of Crocs up herself.
I love you all. I'm Caitlin's biggest fucking fan.
Oh my god. They're all fans of you. What are you talking about?
Follow me on my app. I'm a big fan of you.
Follow me on Instagram.
Gigi Williams underscore X.
Maddie Law.
On TikTok.
Mads Law.
Oh yeah, she's
Mads Law.
Famous
on TikTok over here.
That is what I can't do.
Oh my god.
Live it's all about me, 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 me. Sorry. I just wanted to be an intro.
It's the update. We've got a Moscow Mule.
Yeah, Moscow Mule and Long Island on the go.
This is like the early lowdown, you know?
I feel like
I love your makeup. Bakery and getting something. Oh, good evening, Chad from Paddleton.
Right, okay, model, turn around.
Whoa.
Still in Paris, fashion week.
Oh, I wish. They wouldn't let me in.
Just two friends discussing their love of coats.
It's Paris, isn't it? Like, sometimes you just got to sit down.
Put an effort in, exactly. You know what I mean?
That's my mind.
Listen, there's no excuse for a bad outfit. There's no excuse. You wake up every day, you put on clothes, why are you putting on bad ones?
I got Crocs on. They're fake, everyone.
Are they?
I came to the Croc Society.
You're so fake, Millie. You're so
they're
fake.
They're from like Wilco's or something.
That's
like some garden centre.
Like literally, that's
I've had them since I was 12.
Great leg Crocs.
Even Gigi thought these were real Crocs.
No, like, tell me these aren't real Crocs.
They are.
So real. I have no idea where they're from.
Garrison.
Yeah, they're literally like Wilco or from like garden centre.
Decathlon. Yeah, Amazon.
I can text my mum.
Shein.
Mum, where are my Crocs from?
I got my Crocs on Shein.
Shein. Guys, my Crocs are from Shein. I just thought they were like so trendy.
Oh my god. Birthday boy.
Happy birthday.
Welcome to my YouTube channel.
Pizza!
Hi, my name is Cody Booker and I will be auditioning for the role of Rock. Thank you very much.
Why did you do a Rock so well?
I guess like, I'm just a prodigy.
He looks like he's like constipated. What's your big three?
Leo, Gemini.
Oh my god. Aww. So basically you're just really self-obsessed.
I'm self-obsessed and two-faced.
Why are we friends? It's fine. I'm like self-obsessed, overly emotional, and really stubborn. Because I'm Cancer, Leo, Taurus.
I don't know what I am, because my mom can't remember when I was born. Sad. I texted her, she was like, yeah, I don't remember. I think it was that, and then she was like, oh, sorry, your dad said it was like to be in the evening. I was
so
like,
we'll never know. We'll never know. Guys, I love Gigi. Look how crazy, I look so fucking crazy at this angle, like.
You're crazy for me as well.
I'm gonna side-eye you if you walk in here with jeggings.
Jeggings, I should leave those in 2011 or wherever they're from.
If half her shit isn't fucking thrifted, I won't speak to you. Says everyone here is wearing something from ASOS. Everyone is wearing
something
from ASOS.
Shein.
Yeah, Shein and ASOS. Everyone's talking about.
No way. I hate Shein. I really am fucked.
My host kid was awesome. Starting with me. Right, ready? Oh, three, two, one.
You took heart award.
Okay, go. Yeah.
These are Led Zeppelin.